And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Leclerc, Sainz. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's sprint. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Perez, Hamilton, George Russell, and Verstappen, Norris, Fernando Alonso, Ocon, and Pierre Gasly. Old-timer, Bottas, Yuki Tsunoda, and Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Vettel, Lance Stroll, and Guan Yu Zhou, Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. And with preparations almost complete, let's head trackside for today's sprint. Here we go then, the formation lap is underway ahead of today's sprint. We're almost ready to start the sprint as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Charles Leclerc currently leading the... Welcome from the beautiful Styrian Mountains for another chapter in the story of the Austrian Grand Prix. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 meters above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of around 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill of turn three. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Oldtimer, Max Verstappen, and Hamilton, Russell, Norris, Fernando Alonso, and Pierre Gasly, Tsunoda, Ocon, Valtteri Bottas, and Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Stroll, Sebastian Vettel, and Guan Yu Zhou, Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. Why don't we discuss McLaren? What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
The formation lap gets underway and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. We're almost ready to start the race as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
okay. Now stay alert for threats around you. window, you're going to be on soft. Right, they've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Open, so let's box this lap, box this lap. To your teammate behind is 3.8 seconds. Lando's coming in for his stop now. Lando. issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Approaching one of the Ferraris. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Ahead is 2.9 seconds. Seconds. Aggression, please, we don't want to lose places because of a penalty. Right, we've got enough OK, this is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
Performance from Ferrari, it hardly looked in doubt. Tell me, Ant, how do they manage to achieve this win?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. Let's see how the driver's standings have changed. Charles Leclerc, currently leading the championship standings, extends his lead even further with this result. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Charles Leclerc showed exactly how to manage yourself out on the track today. He was almost flawless out there. Incredible stuff.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. No change in the top spot then, but with today's points, their hold on that lead is getting weaker.
The contract renewal window has opened. We can try and renegotiate for a better deal with our current team, or approach someone else. Here you can make salary demands to the team. Any extra over your base salary will go into your perk fund. The more you demand, the lower the chances of our success. Do make sure that you don't go demanding anything unrealistic for your acclaim level. If you do, the team might refuse to negotiate any more with you in this negotiation period. Here's where you can buy perks to become a better driver both on and off the track. Any fee you negotiate over your base salary in the contract negotiation is cash you can spend on these perks.